Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So I thought for today's video we could do a really fun little Christmas DIY. So I'm going to be upcycling some baubles and turning them into colors that are definitely more my aesthetic, because I feel like a lot of the time Christmas decorations are either super expensive if you want to go down the like designer route and get something extremely specific, or they're just like really cheap and sometimes a little bit tacky, which by the way, I love tacky Christmas decorations, do not get me wrong, but I just think sometimes around my home, particularly with having a certain style, that sometimes I just want to customize things and make them a little bit more what I am into. So thought I could show that to you guys, how I'm gonna do that little DIY, because it is a beautiful sunny day here in Melbourne, and whenever I do any painting stuff it takes an eternity to dry here because it's normally so cold. So we're gonna do it today because it's the perfect day for it. And before we do that, I am gonna show you my Christmas cocktail. I made this up myself, so you guys can definitely copy it. And I think it is a really fun idea for a beautiful, yummy Christmas cocktail. So let's get straight into that first, because then I can drink that while I'm doing the little DIY after. So hope you guys really enjoy this one. And just a super quick reminder, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. I put up new videos every single week. Okay, so these are the ingredients I've grabbed for my Emma's Christmas cocktail. And if you are in Australia, you'll definitely be able to find these at your local Coles or Woolworths, but if not, I'm sure you could find substitute items because they're pretty like common things. But well, I mean, except for Bundaberg, right? Because Bundy's Australian. But I have these, which are the Bundaberg spiced ginger beer. They're non-alcoholic and it has Christmas flavors of cinnamon and cloves. So absolutely love the sound of those. And it just came in a 4-pack of these cute little bottles. So even if you were just gonna stock those in your fridge for Christmas, I think that would look super cute. So grabbed a bunch of those. And then what I thought I would pop into it to kind of make it more like a little cocktail is some cherry juice. So I'll put in a little dash of this 100% cherry juice from Bickford's, which is an amazing cordial brand, by the way. They do really, really nice stuff. And I also then got this packet of glacé cherries, because I always feel like one of my favorite cocktails is like an amaretto sour and it has glacé cherries in it. And I don't really like these, but I feel like I always end up eating it anyway when it's in cocktails. So thought I would grab those to kind of pair with the cherry juice. And as a little garnish, I have these beautiful little sprigs of rosemary. So to pop that all in, I'm just using my glasses from Kmart, and you can get really inexpensive kind of crystally looking glasses like this from Kmart, IKEA, all sorts of places now, because I think they're really in style. So that's what we're going to be working with. I'm just going to pop some ice into the glass and then we can make and do a little taste test of my invention, and I'll see if it's any good. All right, welcome to Emma's cocktail lounge. Step one, I'm gonna pop some ice into the glass. Next, I have to try and get this impossible ring pull off this thing without freaking out that I'm gonna break. Oh, that was, hang on, wait. Ooh, that was so easy. I thought those were really like masculine looking bottle pops, but that was super duper easy. So I'm gonna fill probably to just over halfway, I guess. We'll see how much I get out of this bottle, because I wanna try and do two. All right, these are really generous actually. That almost filled up the glass. Next, I'm gonna pop in a dash of the cherry juice. I'm not gonna put too much of this in because I feel like it would be quite concentrated, so I might just pour it into the cap and splash that in. It looks really cool. I love that it just turned the whole thing bright red. And now the last step is to add a couple of these glacé cherries, which I think looks super cool. So I want to pop them in there as a little bit of a garnish, because I just think that will look really, really beautiful and also add a little bit of flavor as well. Now to finish it off with the sprigs of rosemary. And we are done. You have some little Christmas cocktails. Thank you. Yum. I am not even joking. If you can go and get your hands on this ingredient, go and make this cocktail and let me know what you think, because that is absolutely delicious. And it looks really beautiful and festive as well. I think I'm definitely going to buy up this stuff again and take it to my partner's family Christmas and make it all for them, because I love this. And if you wanted to make it an alcoholic version, you could definitely just spike it with a shot of vodka. But for me, I find myself drinking less and less these days. So having some really beautiful, delicious, non-alcoholic options for me is really amazing. And I love how festive and fun this is. This just looks so cute, so festive, and it tastes absolutely delicious. Okay, so you'll need a handful of things to do this DIY, and it is probably looking a little bit scarier than it actually is, but as are all DIYs, because I feel like I bought this stuff and I have an idea of how it will go down, but then when you actually try and do it, it's always a little bit different or a little bit harder. But I have this giant box of Christmas baubles. There's blue ones, gold ones, white and silver sort of ones, and this was literally like, I don't know, maybe $5 or something from Kmart. So inexpensive if anything gets messed up, but I just thought I'd put a couple around my house, and these are essentially a bunch of leftovers, but I want to paint them up and color them in a way that I'll really like. I've got some paper towel to put down underneath my workstation. I saved two pieces of foam from just like a delivery box thing that I had. And in that, I am thinking I'm going to use these bamboo skewers to, like, once I've painted them, I'll like thread it on and then like put the skewer in there so that they can all sit there and dry. And then in terms of the paint, I got this sample pot in the color terracotta. And this was just from the local Bunnings. And that is really handy because there were some really beautiful colors up on the wall. And I just went up to the guy at the desk and I was like, can I just get a sample pot of just like a little tiny amount of that? So that was $10. And then I just went and bought this natural white sample pot, which was $5. And I thought I can use this color directly. I can also mix it with a bit of white and kind of dilute it into a bunch of different shades. And just for fun, I got some Christmas plates because I need something to put this paint on, and I didn't want to put it on my actual plates and potentially like ruin them if it's not like water-based and won't come off, because it is like proper paint, I guess. So that's my theory. I'm going to get my little workstation set up and I'll mix in the colors, and then we can have a go at doing this little DIY. Colors that I ended up with, you would have seen me painting with so far. I've kind of got a full terracotta and then a beautiful light dusky kind of terracotta. And this is my messy little workstation. Some of the foam has kind of popped out, but I feel like this is working pretty well. I worked out if you actually grab the ball and like shove it onto the skewer, then it sits there a little bit more secured. So that's kind of where we're at. I'm just painting half each color. So I'm just gonna do the rest of them. And I haven't kind of done that many because I just wanna see how they dry. And I was just gonna fill up a little bowl with them as a little decoration. So let's keep going and I'll show you the finished product.
I'm always
Well, that is it for today's video. I hope you guys really enjoyed coming along for this fun festive video. And if you do try that drink recipe, absolutely let me know in the comments, because I think it is super delicious, really quick and easy to make. And I was kind of surprised with how good that was, to be honest. I think that Bundaberg spiced ginger beer is definitely like a limited edition thing. So go and get your hands on that if you can find it in store. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.